Hello students, welcome to biology world. In previous video we have to discuss about the fifth chapter, morphology of flowering plant. But next week we have to conduct the biology test. In this biology test we include two chapters, chapter number 2 biological classification and chapter number 5 morphology of flowering plants. In chapter 2 biological classification we have to include the portion starting with fungi and up to last year, lichens and viroids. And now fifth chapter, morphological of flowering plant, the first topic, the root, is including this case. So you have to learn and study both the chapter very carefully, and this whole week we have to revise this all the both the two chapters and all the topics including in your test. So now today we discuss about your first topic, revision topic, that is Ingram fungi. In previous we have to already done this topic, but including in your next week test, this topic is very much useful and very much important for you. So now basic, today we discuss about the basic structure and basic information about the kingdom fungus. The kingdom fungus most of appear in moist place. Most of it be show in brain, and this is known as brain mold. Fungus is also very much useful in bacterial items, that is unicellular fog. Unicellular fungus is yeast. It is very much useful in bakery products. Now the rust disease caused in wheat plant, this disease is caused by the coccinia. This is a fungus which is caused rust disease in wheat plant. So fungus is useful as well as harmful for our living organisms. The penicillium, this is the most important fungus which is useful in production of antibiotics. The production of antibiotics, it is very much a source of penicillium. So fungus is useful as well as harmful. Now we discuss about this body structure, the unicellular, and most probably the fungus is multicellular. Only yeast is unicellular, and it is your one mark question. Which fungus is including in unicellular? So the yeast is including in the unicellular, and besides this, all the fungi or all the fungus are including in multicellular. Now we discuss about the body organization of the fungus. So you have to know that is the in body organization, the thread like structure. Thread-like structure is known as hyphae. If the hyphae is network-like structure, if the hyphae is network-like, we have to know that mycelium. In some fungus, this mycelium have multinucleated cytoplasm, and we have to known as choanocytic hyphae. The mycelium hyphae and choanocytic hyphae it is the very much useful words for your examination. Define the word hyphae, define the word mycelium, and define the word choanocytic. So this is the basic information of the body organization you have to already learn and study. Now we discuss about the mode of nutrition. occurring fungus. So first, the most probably the fungus is saprophytic because it is totally depend in decomposers. So it is known as saprophytic mode of nutrition. Some fungus are parasitic, which is depend on plants and animals. Some fungus have symbiotic relationship in second chapter last topic is lichen, and we have to study symbiotic relationship with fungus and algae. Most probably and most well known example is lichen, but in this fungus higher roots of plants and fungus, the symbiotic relationship is known as mycorrhiza. So this is a mode of nutrition occurs in fungus kingdom. And now we discuss about the most important topic of this kingdom fungi is reproduction. So we have to know that two types of reproduction is possible: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In fungus, vegetative reproduction is also occur, and vegetative reproduction is done by fission multifission and fission fragmentation. Binary fission, it is a vegetative reproduction. Now we discuss about the asexual reproduction. The asexual reproduction is done by the spores, and these spores are known as conidia. This is also your one mark question: what is conidia? Conidia or defined our conidia. So in fungus, asexual reproduction is done by the spores, and these spores are known as conidia. Most probably spores are produced during asexual reproduction. The sexual reproduction is also done by the spore production. Besides this, the sexual reproduction is complete in three steps. These three steps are very much important for you students. First step is plasmogamy. And you have to very well know what is plasmogamy. The fusion of two motile or non-motile gametes, cytoplasm. This cytoplasm or fusion of the cytoplasm of two motile and non-motile gametes are known as plasmogamy. The second one is karyogamy. The fusion of two nuclei of gametes, this is known as karyogamy. And third step is meiosis. So the haploid spores are produced. So this is the main three step which is occur in sexual reproduction in fungus. First one is plasmogamy, fusion of protoplasm of two non-motile or motile gametes. Second one is karyogamy, fusion of two nuclei. And third one is meiosis, haploid spores are produced. So this is the sexual reproduction in fungus. Students, ask like write down the short form of asexual reproduction in fungus. Second one is write down the three main step of sexual reproduction in fungus. Both are here and both are the main question of your syllabus. Now last we discuss that main most probably phases are occur in fungus in karyogamy, plasmogamy and meiosis. Sexual reproduction have two haploid gametes are combined and fertilization is complete. But in some case the gametes are rapidly divided and form of three end phase, and this is known as dikaryon phase. So you have to also ask in examination, define the word dikaryon phase. In sexual reproduction of fungus, most probably gametes are divided and fusion, but in some basidiomycetes class it is rapidly divided and N and M combine both, and second one another gametes are included and form the three end phase. It is known as dikaryon phase. Sorry, here two one rapidly N and M combine and give the dikaryon. Di means two. Dikaryon phase. So it is known as dikaryous process. Di means two, and karyosis means nucleus. So both the gametes are fused. Both the gametes nucleus are fused and form the two end phase. And this phase is known as dikaryon phase. So this is the most probably and most asking question in examination. Here we have to study the basic information about the fungus. In this topic, in question bank, you have to ask many question, 1 mark or 2 marks. Prepare well, and if you have to any doubt, ask me. We will solve your doubts. All the very best, and thank you.